A night at the theater. What would you do if you were sitting in a theater and during the performance, a man's hand brushed against your thigh? And what would you do if that hand belonged to the most desirable man you've ever seen? And what would you do if, prior to this, the last physical contact you had with a man was so long ago you can't even remember? What, I ask you, would you do? Well, I'll tell you what I did, but first you need to know how I found myself in such a situation. I was approaching the theater for the 8 o'clock show when my cell rang. It was my girlfriend, Andrea. Something had come up at work, she said, and she couldn't make it. I couldn't believe my ears. Something had come up at work? The tickets to the show were my birthday gift. From Andrea. She'd given them to me just the week before. And now, here she was on the cell phone saying how sorry she was about the whole situation, how she promised to make it up to me in a big way. Andrea said I should sell her ticket and keep the money, since it was a gift. I clicked off the cell phone completely frustrated. From behind me, I heard a low voice. "Excuse me, would you happen to have an extra ticket?" I turned around. Standing 3 inches taller than me was a man in a long, tan coat draped over a dark silk shirt and dark pants. He was extraordinarily attractive. He had a slightly broken nose, but it was beautiful, despite or because of the slight imperfection. And he had full, sensuous lips. His short, dark hair had streaks of gray, and his dark eyes were large and clear. But it was his smile that captured me. I sold him the ticket immediately. I was trying to figure out how to keep him engaged before the show started when he offered me his arm up the stairs. How gallant. He told me his name was Philip, and he had just closed a big deal at the office. He said this new musical was a gift for himself. I told him it was my birthday and that my girlfriend Andrea, who had canceled on me at the last moment, had given me the tickets. "Well, as it's your birthday, I'll have to buy you a glass of champagne at intermission. We both have something to celebrate, it seems." As we took our seats, the orchestra was tuning their instruments. Philip and I began talking as though we'd known each other forever. We discovered we were both on the same crazy diet, loved reading thrillers, loved the same sitcoms, and loved Impressionism. Why, I asked myself, did someone not introduce me to this man before? Gradually, the conversation took on a more personal tone, and Philip told me he'd broken up with his girlfriend 6 months ago and hadn't dated since. I told Philip I had resigned from the dating scene a year ago after a bad date. Since then, my girlfriends had tried to set me up, but I always refused. Where was the romance in a prearranged date with a stranger? I made a funny face, and Philip laughed. The lights dimmed, and the musical began. Somewhere in the first 20 minutes of the performance, it happened. I felt Philip's knuckles brush along my leg as he reached for his fallen program. Now, it's possible that a man who is sitting next to you in the dark might accidentally touch your leg. Such things do happen. I hoped, however, that the contact was deliberate. I'm not desperate. I'm attractive. I'm bright and funny. I just don't have time or energy for dating in today's world. I'm successful at what I do, but it takes a lot of time. I'm also very involved in politics, have 2 dogs at home, lots of friends, and, well, you get the picture. I was used to my life. I had almost forgotten about lust. Philip's hand brushing my thigh awakened my dormant passion. 5 minutes passed, and then with my heart crashing against my chest, I moved my leg over and lightly touched my knee to his. I was keeping my eyes forward as though watching the performance on stage, but I couldn't tell you anything that I supposedly saw. I was keenly aware of Philip's breathing, the hardness of his knee against mine, and that as he readjusted his arm on our shared armrest, our elbows touched lightly. My knee and my elbow. Now there were 2 points of physical contact. Was he aware of the subtle electric current that flowed between us? Did he feel the mounting sexual tension? Or was he oblivious to the heat emanating from me? Couldn't he feel the pulsing beat of my blood? My heart sank the next moment as he moved his arm and knee away. So the physical contact had been incidental after all. Then I felt his leg press against mine. This time there was no mistaking his intention. An electrifying bolt shot through me. Before I could think of how to respond, the curtain rang down on the first act. The time had come for intermission. In the lobby, I got my promised glass of champagne, and Philip and I talked as if nothing had happened in the darkened theater. Perhaps nothing had. Perhaps I'd imagined everything. Then, before I knew it, the bells were ringing. It was time to return to our seats. This time, Philip took my arm and pulled me close to him as we moved down the aisle. I placed my hand over his wrist and caressed the back of his hand with my fingertips. It was my birthday, and I was throwing caution to the wind. Just before we took our seats, Philip took me by surprise when he ran the tip of his forefinger along the back of my neck. I gasped as shivers rippled through me. We sat down, the lights dimming, and Philip suddenly leaned towards me. Whispering in my ear, he asked what perfume I was wearing. I made him repeat the question, not because I hadn't heard him, but because I liked the tingle of his breath on my ear. He repeated the question, and I turned to him and whispered the name of the perfume. He said he was going to buy some the very next day. When I asked him why, he answered that it would remind him of me. Before I could respond, the woman behind us leaned forward and asked us to be quiet. Philip and I shared a silent laugh. Then I mouthed the words, "Come here." Not until I made a little gesturing motion with my forefinger did he lean closer. I kissed him on the lips, those full and sensuous lips, then said, "Maybe that will help you remember me." Philip was staggered. I motioned for him to lean back in for another whispered message. "This has turned out to be a wonderful birthday," I said. In response, Philip took my face in his hands and kissed me very softly. Later that night, I entered my apartment and found the light flashing on my answering machine. The message was from the friend who had bought me the tickets. "Hope you enjoyed the musical. Philip phoned me a minute ago." Yes, the Philip you were just with. It wasn't easy getting him to show up like that. It took weeks of convincing. Of course, I would have set you guys up ages ago, but you said you'd never go on a blind date. Anyway, I promised I would make up missing the show to you. Hope I have. Oh, yeah, and by the way, Philip is crazy about you. Bye. I stared at the answering machine for a moment, and then my face broke into a huge smile.
Listen, touch, and